Well, it appears that we have the attorneys coming out. We have the attorneys, Jim Acosta and Ted Boutros, attorney for CNN.
We're extremely pleased with the ruling today. This is a great day for the First Amendment in journalism. We're very excited to have Mr. Acosta be able to go back and get his hard pass and report the news about the White House. I'll turn it over to Jim.
Okay. Everybody, thanks for coming. I just want to say something very briefly, and that is I want to thank all of my colleagues in the press who supported us this week. And I want to thank the judge for the decision he made today. And let's go back to work. Thank you.
Simple, short, and sweet from Ted Boutros, attorney for CNN there. It's a great day for the First Amendment and for journalism. And that's a point we've been highlighting throughout the coverage of this story. As we have noted on this air, a number of news organizations across the board, print and television, including Fox News, came out in support of this because they saw this as a precedent that would affect more than just CNN, but other news outlets. I wonder if we could bring back Jessica Schneider just for a moment as you heard that there, because the judge in his commentary in there did take down some of the government's, the White House's arguments, said that it was of questionable accuracy that Jim Acosta, for instance, placed his hands on the intern, but also said very, very explicitly that it would have caused irreparable harm to Acosta and CNN to keep the pass, to keep that pass revoked. So some fairly strong words from the judge, even in what was a limited ruling.
Right, exactly. And the judge here really had to follow the case law in the D.C. circuit. And one of the overriding cases was from a journalist that was excluded from the White House back in the 1960s and 1970s. So the judge had to strictly adhere to that ruling. And the judge made the point that while the White House has said that CNN has 50 other employees which are hard pass eligible, that have those hard passes, it didn't matter that in this case, this was about an individual journalist. This is about an individual journalist's rights, in this case, the due process rights, and whether or not those were violated, in which case the judge here said that there was the likelihood of success that they would prove that those due process rights were violated. But it didn't matter that CNN has a whole cadre of journalists, photojournalists, reporters, producers. What mattered was Jim Acosta as an individual journalist and the fact that his due process rights were likely violated here, that he didn't get the opportunity to be heard, or there wasn't any clear notification, and it was unclear who exactly made this decision. The reasoning from the government, from the White House, was jumbled. The judge did reference that as well. He said that initially, Sarah Sanders mentioned that Jim Acosta had placed his hand on that intern who tried to take the microphone away. But then the judge also noted that in later statements, that reasoning wasn't mentioned. And the White House simply referred to disrespectful conduct on the part of Mr. Acosta. So he said that was problematic as well. But yes, the judge definitely ruling that it is the individual journalist's rights that should not be interfered with in this case. It doesn't matter about the organization as a whole and whether or not they have other journalists to supplant Jim Acosta in this case. It matters for the individual right of a journalist and their press freedom and their due process rights. Guys?
Yeah. Well, the law matters. We've seen it here. We saw it with the Muslim ban. We saw it with family separation at the border. The judges step up for the law.
Jessica Schneider, great reporting. Thank you. Let's bring back in Jeffrey Toobin and Brian Stelter. You know, Jeffrey, I've always been proud to call Jim Acosta a colleague and a friend. But just those words, all he said was, let's get back to work. This is not about him. This is about press freedom, and he will go back to work today.
And look, the criticism of Acosta is always that he's too aggressive. He's a showboat. That's what you hear on Fox News, that he grandstands. But you saw the real Jim Acosta just now, very simply, saying he wants to get back to work. Look, there's a lot to cover at this White House. There's a lot to cover in the Trump presidency. We need to have reporters on the front lawn covering these stories every day, including Jim Acosta. So it's an important moment for press freedom in the U.S. because this entire case is a test of the rights that we have in America for coverage of the White House, for coverage of politicians, and even reporters in other states, you know, who cover state houses, mm-hmm. who cover city councils. Yeah. They're watching this, too. Because a tone, again, always gets set from the top. The president's attacks on the press are endless, but today the institutions worked. The courts ruled in the favor of the free press. And of course, as Jessica was saying, limited ruling. We will see what happens down the line. but it was an important first round.
And what was so striking about this was the unanimity of the press corps. Everyone from the New York Times to Fox News itself saying, this is not right,
because
what happened to Jim Acosta.
Because they know it could be them.
Well, that's right. And you know, one way of looking at what Jim Acosta was accused of doing was being too aggressive with follow-up questions. Another word for that is journalism.
There you go.
And that goes, and if that results in losing your ability to do your livelihood, throwing you out of the press corps, that's a threat to everyone who covers, I mean, as Brian said, not just the White House, but state houses and city halls.
Think of the precedent. I said this on the air the other day.
Right.
The only other personal experience I've had of this is in China, where China rejected and overturned and took away press credentials because they didn't like the questions asked or the coverage of the stories. I'm not saying the U.S. is China. I'm just saying that there's a commonality
there,
right?
You don't want to get even close to that.
There's a lot to protect about the American experiment. Mm-hmm. This is part of it. And CNN just issued a statement, both CNN and Acosta. I'll read it to you. It says, we are gratified with this ruling, this result, and we look forward to a full resolution in the coming days. Our sincere thanks to all who have supported not just CNN, but a free, strong, and independent press.
But I do think it is worth pointing out that this process is not over. The White House has a choice to make now.
To proceed.
That they can, it seems to me, call Jim Acosta in and say, look, we really thought what you did was wrong. We hope you knock it off, but let's shake hands and move on. Mm-hmm. That, to me, is the smart resolution. Alternatively, the judge did give them an invitation to say, we are going to establish procedures. We are going to continue to try to take away your hard pass. We are going to continue this battle.
Right.
The White House now has to choose which of those courses to go.
Yeah, and we know the president loves to fight. He loves to pick these fights,
and, you know,
but he lost today.
And he's already been fundraising off of this fight with CNN.
He could make a political judgment that continuing this in the courts, even if it's a loser, eventually is in his political interest. And he's made decisions like that before.
We shall see.
Thank you.
Jeffrey, Brian, thanks very much for covering this throughout. Quite a fascinating story for us to cover
certainly.
As well.